Happening here, WaterFire Providence is about to kick off another great weekend of fun in the capital city. And this weekend, the flames will be lit in honor of Chinese Culture Night. And it will also include, this is great, a salute to our educators here in Rhode Island. And here now to tell us all about the upcoming event is Bronwyn Dannenfelser of WaterFire Providence, along with Education Commissioner Deborah Gist and the Teacher of the Year himself, David Moscarelli. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's nice to have a full sofa here. So many great things to talk about. Bronwyn, we'll have you lead us off here today. Talk to us about what people can expect at tomorrow night's big WaterFire event.
It's going to be massive and gorgeous. Well, one, the weather's gorgeous, so that's perfect. Mm-hmm. It's sponsored by Webster Bank and the Confucius Institute. So as you said, and as you're opening, we are going to be celebrating Chinese culture. So there will be dragon performances and all sorts of, on Steeple Street. We're essentially turning it into Little China. So,
that's,
you know,
terrific.
Educate people on Chinese culture, which is very important, and lots of fun. There'll be dragons on the river, starting at 5:30 on the basin stage, all sorts of performances. And then also, starting earlier, we are so proud to partner with the Rhode Island Department of Education mm-hmm. and have our salute to teachers. We've been working with Deborah for, gosh, months now, putting this together. Well, yeah. We'll be saluting 75 Rhode Island educators, and really looking forward to it.
It's terrific. And Deborah, you'll actually be speaking at WaterFire, and you'll be sort of, you know, getting everybody, you know, informing them as to what's going on, honoring this guy, and really just letting people know what this is all about.
Absolutely. I'll be speaking. David will be speaking.
And I'll be speaking.
You'll all be speaking. We're so excited because this is just a chance to raise the spotlight to wonderful educators. And it's our Teachers of the Year. It's teachers who've won other really prestigious awards, as well as our Principals of the Year. And so this is a chance just to give them a moment to shine. They're going to march toward the basin with a torch procession. It's going to be absolutely fabulous.
That's terrific. And it's so nice that, you know, we can spotlight the terrific work that educators do. My dad was a principal. He's retired now. My mother is a teacher. So I know firsthand just how important the work is that teachers do. And David, you know, talk to us about what it's like to have that recognition. I mean, how did you feel when you found out that you were being honored?
Well, I was completely shocked and humbled. I mean, we rarely have the spotlight on us. We prefer to have the spotlight on our students.
Sure.
As your mom and father know. And to be able to kind of step up and represent the 13,000 educators that are working every day in Rhode Island is something I'm extremely proud to do.
When you found out, were you just right away overwhelmed, or did you just think, oh, like you said, I want the credit to go to the kids, or did you just try to enjoy it?
I tried to enjoy it. I mean, there's no doubt it's been very overwhelming thus
sure.
far. But it's been a great ride, and getting to work at RIDE at the Department of Ed has been really amazing to kind of get to see all the work they're doing to support us that we sometimes don't recognize.
Definitely. But let's be honest, the best part of being a teacher is handing out detentions. come on.
I don't do too many of those. Like, my students have been great to me.
Well, certainly we offer you our highest congratulations. And Bronwyn, you know, it's really remarkable how WaterFire has grown, you know, from where it started to the fact that you can honor teachers, we can celebrate Chinese culture. It's just tremendous.
Yeah, and you know, one of the things that we want to make sure people do not miss is on the Washington Street Bridge, we have a resource fair. So we've got all different exhibits of what different schools are doing, from robotics to the STEM programs to the artwork.
Student music will be there. Yeah,
it's terrific. Well, Bronwyn, always great to see you. Oh, Deborah, a pleasure to meet you. And David, congratulations to you as well. Both of you guys, really, for all the great work you're doing.
Thank you.
All right. Well, if you guys want to check out WaterFire this weekend, head over to downtown Providence tomorrow night, of course. The flames will be lit shortly before sunset around 6:30 p.m.